Just look where Aussie families are striking it rich. A job where the boss pays your rent, buys you a car, sends your kids to a private school, and gives you an overseas holiday every year. All that with a special added bonus. There's no income tax, not a cent. It's all happening in Dubai, the fastest growing place on earth. Thousands of Australians are flocking there to join this 21st century gold rush as the sheiks spend squillions carving a modern metropolis out of the desert. You've never seen anything like it. Even the Aussies helping to build the new Dubai are gobsmacked. They just can't believe their luck. The legendary desert sands of Arabia have been shifting endlessly through time. But in recent years, this serene force of nature has been buried under a man-made tsunami of construction in the city of Dubai.
Dubai rising from the desert.
That's right. It's rising from the sand, yes.
Dubai, part of the United Arab Emirates, is home to an estimated 20% of the world's cranes and is undergoing a building boom never experienced anywhere on the globe. Here in the troubled Middle East, they're flat out building a citadel of capitalism. A playground of extravagance and unadulterated wealth.
Green diamond eye.
Well, it's emerald.
Emerald, of course.
Yeah. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, Your Highness. Peter Overton, how do you do?
Welcome to Dubai.
Thank you very much. Thank
Sheikh
you
Ahmed bin Saeed Al Maktoum is a Crown Prince of Dubai, a member of the ruling royal family who are engineering the incredible transformation of this once sleepy port town on the Persian Gulf.
Just keep building, keep expanding.
You know, I think this is what the area needs here is nobody else is doing much about it. So we have to take that advantage by making Dubai the hub for aviation, trade, business.
How big is big enough?
I don't know.
It's relentless. Everything here has to be the tallest, the grandest, the best. And to make it happen, they've opened their doors to the world. All the major corporations charging in for their slice of the action.
That's not your normal lift.
No, this is a standard construction lift.
80% of the population are foreigners, including 12,000 Australians, lured by the big bucks and big opportunities.
It's unbelievable. I've never seen so much construction in my life.
No, I don't think you will anywhere else in the world. It's something else, that's for sure. You have to see it to believe it. And this is just a small part. I mean, Dubai is over 40 kilometres long and it's like this the whole way.
Now, how long ago was this just desert?
About 3 years ago.
Australian project manager Andrew Watson works for construction company ALEC, part of a massive multinational workforce that's creating Dubai's skyline.
So if you're into building skyscrapers, this is your utopia, is it?
This is the place. It's a place to be.
Out of a fight, I think, one night, I said to Andrew, we just need to move away from here. And I actually meant Canberra or somewhere close at home. I didn't actually mean over here. But he came in going, oh, have you heard of Dubai? I had to do a Google search. I had no idea where it was. So that's how it all started.
Yeah.
I say, hi, Grandma.
Hi, Grandma.
This time last year, the Watsons lived just around the corner from Andrew's parents in suburban Sydney. Then they were a young family of four struggling to survive.
That's where we were. We were
it was so
three
stressful.
Months away from divorce.
You know.
So, or the bank manager come and taking the house.
Mm.
So they sold up everything and headed to the Middle East and are now laughing all the way to the bank.
Company pays for my rent. They buy me a car. They give us international travel every year. They pay for my children to go to private school. So all those costs that we normally have back home, we just simply don't have here. On top of that, we don't pay any income tax. So it actually means that I'm now saving, we hope, the equivalent of what I was earning in Sydney.
You can't wipe the smile off your face hearing that.
I have not stopped laughing since the day I landed on the plane, off the plane. I love it.
It wasn't so long ago Dubai was just a small tax-free trading port under the protection of the British. Pearls, fishing and gold smuggling sustained a town of just 10,000 people. It was a backwater until they discovered oil in 1966.
Were camels part of your life then?
No, I think that's maybe before.
But your
before
parents?
Me. Yes, my parents and my father. But a lot of, we had cars, I mean, from the early, as let's say, 50s or...
What do you drive today?
For sure not a camel.
Where camels roamed only a few years ago, luxury cars now jam 14-lane freeways. Where once there was only sea, giant islands in the shape of palm trees, even a map of the world, have been dredged up and spat out. The theory being, when the oil runs out in 15 years, Dubai will be the international trade and tourism mecca. The old Dubai had a coastline of about 60 kilometres, but it wasn't enough. Legend has it, the ruler decreed, build more beaches, and so they did. In fact, they created a whole new world. This is England, yours for about $40 million. Now, I know it's not very patriotic, they're still building Australia. But if you think constructing the world is a big project, just have a look at what they're doing down there. Just imagine this. 3 years ago, in this very spot, I'd be floating in the ocean. The shoreline was 10 kilometres away. Not anymore. This is the Palm Jebel Ali development, the world's biggest man-made island. And it will soon be home to a quarter of a million people. Here in Dubai, money is clearly no object. You're only limited by your imagination.
Angela, have they ever seen snow before?
Never. This is our first time ever seeing snow, and here in sunny Dubai, it's very, very surreal.
It is, isn't it? It's bizarre.
It's more than bizarre. It's what a way to tell them. The first time you saw snow is in the middle of the desert, you know.
I don't think they get it. I think they're wondering, why is it so cold?
Where's my gloves?
One, two, three!
It's not hard to see why they called Dubai Disneyland in the desert. It has a real sense of the make-believe. If it's not here today, chances are it will be by tomorrow.
You must have seen some almost jaw-dropping sights in terms of the opulence and the wealth in this place.
Yeah, I've never seen as many poor Cheyennes on the road. I'd pass 20 every day, and that's... When you're not passing those, you're passing Mercedes-Benzes and you're passing BMWs. And
the women are glamorous. They're absolutely glamorous, dripping with diamonds and bling.
Which brings us to Dubai's first lady of bling. Samia Galadari, daughter of a property magnate and a very modern Muslim woman.
You think you're the global example of, the, of all the best cultures around the world?
Yes, yes, I've taken everything off.
In this Muslim country, many women opt for the traditional dress, the abaya, not Samia. She sees herself as the personification of the new cosmopolitan Dubai.
All the top designers are here, like Cartier is here, and Yves Saint Laurent.
Our religion doesn't really say that we have to cover ourselves. Why on earth should women look horrible and ugly and covered up? I just didn't believe in this, you know.
So it's not the abaya, it's Dolce & Gabbana. For you, and you're very comfortable.
And I'm comfortable, yes.
Well, you look fantastic. How much is your jewellery worth, may I ask? I've never seen anything like it.
Well, I can't remember the price.
Dubai is a place of outrageous fortune, but it does have a dark side. Critics claim it's a 21st century city being built by a 19th century labour force. There's an army of 500,000 barely trained, lowly paid workers, mainly from India and Pakistan. The heat is intense and some of their living conditions insufferable.
Is it Dubai never sleeps for these guys?
For sure. Well, here we are, it's 7:15 at night. Our second shift has just started. So 1,500 men just left and another 1,500 just arrived.
And is that 24/7, 365 days of the year?
Not quite. There are a few public holidays here, Muslim calendar holidays. But typically it's 360 days a year, yes.
Do you feel sorry for these guys? It's hard work.
It is hard work, but we have to compare where they come from. We treat them well here on site, we give them good conditions, we make it as safe as possible.
In 2004, human rights groups estimated 800 workers died on work sites in Dubai. It's an open wound. The government, ever conscious of its international image, recently moved to heal.
There are certain people or group who are really mistreated by the companies. It's not really that the government sometimes unaware of, and this is why we've been developing our laws, our policies on all those people who come and work here.
Because Dubai's construction industry would fall over without this foreign army of workers.
Yeah, I think it happens in everywhere.
One thing is sure though, the workers will keep coming. This is the honeypot of the Middle East. And it's not just the white and blue collar workers. Dubai wants 15 million tourists a year by 2012. There's nothing subtle about this city's ambition.
It's big and it's bold and some might say it's brassy. But is it sustainable?
You mean everything is going to crash or something? Is that what you're going to say, you think? I don't think that. No, it's not. Every day, more and more people are coming. More and people want to buy and want to invest money.
Dubai is the most lucrative sand pit on the planet, a city literally rising out of the desert and the sea. In just 30 years, it's gone from an obscure sheikdom to an economic powerhouse.
Dubai's number one.
Yes, we're trying to focus that. We will always want to be number one in whatever we do.
In the world.
That's right.
It's still one giant construction site, but this glittering metropolis is fast taking shape. It's no mirage. It's a place where an average Australian family can realise their dreams.
Only in Dubai is our new saying. This could not be any more removed from my normal life than what it is. And that's why I keep laughing. It's a dream. It's just a dream.
I'll get you back. Ready?
Yes.
Hello, I'm Tom Steinfort. Thanks for watching 60 Minutes Australia. Subscribe to our channel now for brand new stories and exclusive clips every week. And don't miss out on our Extra Minutes segments and full episodes of 60 Minutes on 9now.com.au, as well as the 9now app.